under maybe the uncorrupted.
Opposed? It's just showing, well, less than 1 million. I'm just trying to find out if the value change when you sit in it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Fault in, let me see this. Alright, no fault. Alright, no fault. Turn this off.
The restraint system is activated, right?
Well, the module is what will activate it, the ACSM. But the ACSM, I'm going to change it now. I'm just going through some faults just to familiarize myself with it. But it's no fault in that one. Right.
Okay. You can make the engine start.
Oh, yes, I have to look at the wiring and the relay. I have to look at the power distribution. There's a 12 volt supposed to be for ignition and the callback. And they say line is connected, so I have to look where the line is connected. If it's the fuse broken, or if it's the line that comes from, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, 12 volt. Yes,
there's something broken. I'll check it out, but I'm going to deal with the ACSM first, and then I'll check that out. I'm just doing it little by little. And let me get out of this, because time is going. I'm watching my time too. So far the driver's seat has some form of module here. The driver's seat is showing some fault code. I don't know what kind of a fault code is that.
What model is this?
FLA, this one will be the I-beam assistant.
Ah, I-beam.
Yeah, that one, we can rectify.
Everything's working?
One. Yeah, only this module does not respond, the FLA.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, all of these that are in orange, these are they that respond but with fault codes. And so on and so forth.
Erase, eh?
Well, yeah, well, erasing is the easy part, but it's alright. The DME now is in gray.
So, ECU with programming award.
There's no legend here for this one. I don't know. That's certainly in gray.
No, nothing. It's not in gray.
Oh, yeah. You sure that? You see that? Now, let's have to do another vehicle test again. This one is communicating, but the thing is that I reset the ACSM and. Said the module respond properly. You need fault memories. Alright, delete that. Undo the reset control module. If I trigger the component, it's gonna say reset our control unit performed. So you ain't gonna tell. Can't hear no feedback from it other than just what it tells me. And rear seatbelt buckle contacts, bloom, bloom, bloom. Alright, installation of equipment. Is there a, let me see if these things work, because usually when I click them, they're supposed to current value. Installation of rear seatbelt buckle.
Belt count.
Yeah, seat buckle. Let me see. Connect one of them for me. Let me see if there is a change in value. Yeah, we could check the values of them to see if they respond properly. And then we'd have to worry about that part. Contact, current value, seatbelt include. Rear right, rear left. Oh, those.
Is there a way to connect the back ones?
Test the chest?
Yeah.
Test the chest.
Yeah, it worked. All right, you can disconnect the one for me. Hello?
Shit. This one worked.
If this change, I'm not connected?
To connect it.
No! Not change. Nothing. It shows me three connection here. It showed me three things connected here at the bottom. It says Sato seatbelt, bottom contact, rear right, comfort seat in rear passenger compartment only connected.
Connect.
Passenger compartment.
Connect.
So where's the one at the top? Where are these words? Okay. Seatbelt, bottom contact, rear right.
That is rear right.
Yeah, I'm looking at these if you're at the top.
Mm-hmm.
It says rear left, rear right.
But it's not the same?
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out. At least of course I'm let me disconnect them. Just look at the changes.
Mm-hmm.
From this.
Okay.
This. Let me see if anything happened. Anything happened?
No. Nothing. It's still connected.
Alright. Need to find out if it is the ACSM. Well, I think it's that's the one I'm aiming at. I think I'm in the ACSF, the active crash safety model. Let me see. I think that's the one I call the function on. That's the one I'm, yeah, this is it. That's the one I'm in. So I guess I have to change it up because it's not showing any change in it. So,
okay.
Yeah. All right. So let me take a picture of this. Never mind. I'm recording it anyway. So I'll still take a picture of it. Because what I want is to look at these are called central gateway module. Let me look at the ZGM because this is the bus gateway. That's the main. Let me see what
it means.
Central gateway meaning that is the main module in which all the other
main module. Okay.
It's a bus user, but it allows other modules which are bus users to connect through it.
Mm-hmm.
And the diagnosis is done through it. If the, for instance, I get no line communication, I have to troubleshoot the wiring first or the power supply to it, otherwise I'm not going to be able to do anything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because if the let me show you something. I want to go back, but
no, no, yeah. Go on.
Yeah. All right. CGM. Let me see what this.
Oh gosh.
Nick Wama.
Looks really right.
There's no message. Just did. Man, I'm fucking sweating like a hog. Following data, following part data are stored for the checkbox of the company. ZJ, central part memory port, no control unit. So the condition for the part, the central part memory is full. The file saving the central part memory or ambient information are incomplete or not up to date. Condition for port and navigation. Supply was 1896. Terminal R on and then the first one. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.